Alrighty, what's up everybody? It is I, Peter Joseph, back after a couple days off, but I'm back with another video right here. Right here on the official Peter Joseph YouTube Wrestling Channel. YouTube.com/Peter Joseph. Thank you all for watching. Make sure you like the video, hit that subscribe button down there in hell, otherwise known as the screech marks below on this very channel and my other four channels down below in the description box. Show your love and support. Leave a comment on any one of my videos on any one of my channels. But don't leave stupid comments. You go bye-bye. Sent to the Shadow Realm where you will be... You will be destroyed and Satan will eat your soul. That's pretty much it. Don't do it. Trust me, don't do it. But for everybody else who wants to talk about wrestling, music, politics, and anything else, you can do that. But, like I said, don't be stupid. Because you go bye-bye. That's it. Follow me on social media. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And don't forget to share the video all over the internet. Most importantly, tap and slap that bell. Turn on all notifications so you don't miss the next video. Because you miss anything, well, pretty much you're SOL. And I think we all know what that means by now. And if you don't know, please look it up. And that's pretty much it. And if you're brand new here, coming to my channel for the very first time, not like, oh, I've been on YouTube for like 5 years, but I've been on your channel for 5 years, and, you know, making boring as fuck fake channels and shit like that, because you have no life. But brand new people that have just been watching me for the very first time, and you like what you see, you want more, then hit that bell for more to get notified more often, hopefully, if YouTube doesn't fuck up, but that's another story for another time. Hit the bell for more. Turn on all notifications when you hit that bell. If you like, might want more of it, subscribe to my channels. And as we always say, welcome to the party, pal! We hope you enjoy the ride. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. And if you have a cold one, then do that. I don't have one at the moment, but later I will, but not now. Because that's pretty much it. But sit back, relax, grab a cold one, whatever you got, and enjoy the show. Nice, like I said, if you like it, great, you know, get the fuck off my channel. Go watch somebody else with like 4 subs. I mean, not many views, but it is what it is. That's all I gotta say about that. Do whatever you want to do. And that's that. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, on this beautiful, warm, final weekend. Well, actually, take that back. Next weekend is the final weekend of summer, but the penultimate weekend of summer. It is Friday the 13th. Jason Voorhees' birthday. So happy birthday to Jason Voorhees. Well, we have one more in December, so we're going to celebrate today, and then we're going to celebrate in December. But Friday the 13th. 2024, September the 13th, 2024 to be exact. Nice warm day here in New York City. 77 degrees. Gonna be a nice weekend. No rain yet, but we might be getting rain early sometime next week with maybe the remnants of Francine. Not that Francine, but you know. Big ups to Francine, the queen of extreme. I know I took the moniker from, and I gave it to my ex-girlfriend, Ash Marie, who is the Queen of Extreme too, but the original Queen of Extreme, Francine. Big ups to her. Check her out on her channel. And yes, it is. I think it's ECW Francine. Or Francine ECW, one of those. But big ups to her, the Queen of Extreme. Always hangs out with this guy. Right? Get in here, you. The franchise, Shane Douglas. What do you got to say for yourself, Shane? Hey, if you don't like Francine, and if you don't like me, Shane Douglas, the franchise, well, you can suck my ass! Hey, whoa! Easy, Shane. Calm down. Calm down. I just wanted you to say hello to the fans. I don't care! If they don't like me, they can suck my... Okay, we get it. Triple threat, baby. But we move on with that. But yeah, check out Francine on her YouTube channel. She's on social media as well. Tell him I sent you. That's pretty much all I gotta say about that. So we got that. Because I am the God of Extreme. I'm wearing a God shirt, but not the God shirt, but you know. Big ups to my boy, Pyro. Formerly of FSW and Tier 1 and FBW here in New York. Not around anymore. Those promotions, bye! But, you know, sucks. Well, you only got one actual, well, a couple that come around Brooklyn, but it's like one that I can actually go to, but it's neat that I can actually go to, and it's not that far away, but that's WOW, but it's another story for another time. Blah, 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 blah. We move on with that. All right, hope everybody's having a great day. It is, like I said, it's Friday the 13th, Jason Voorhees Day. If you're playing the video game, have fun today. Should be crazy. Pretty much all day today. It's going to be crazy. But we got that. Nice and warm here. Hope everybody has a great weekend. And next weekend is pretty much Friday and Saturday are the last days of summer. Next Sunday is the first day of fall. So the summer, counting down, it is pretty much over. Not officially yet, but we still got about a week to go. A week and a day to go. So got 8 days left of... No, take that back. Yeah, I was right. The 20th. But I don't forget. Whatever it is, next weekend is the official start of fall. So, go with that. And it is what it is. But on this Friday the 13th, we got a lot of videos coming your way today. So stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. Stay tuned. I got this one. I got NXT. I got AEW. And maybe later tonight, SmackDown and Rampage. I will do TNA and Ring of Honor tomorrow. Along with Collision. Saturday night. It is taped, by the way. Not live. I thought it was live, but it's been taped. Not a great episode from what I've seen with the spoilers. Not great, but you know. I mean, the only thing good on is FTR and the Grizzled Young Veterans. That's it. And we got that. But that's tomorrow night on TNT Collision. Well, we got that. SmackDown tonight, the season series / series premiere on the USA Network. I hope you DVR'd it. If you have a DVR and your timer is on Fox, oh, you're going to get something else. So you better have deleted that timer. Go to the USA Network and program your DVR for 8 p.m. I heard you do that yesterday, so I'm good to go. So SmackDown, Dave Butts on the USA Network tonight. Gonna open up with Cody, MDKLA Cody, you bitch. Defending the Undisputed title against Solo Mi Boogie inside a 15-foot tall. Well, 15 feet, well, it's going to be in a 15 feet tall steel cage, brother. So that's going to open the show. I wonder what closes the show. I mean, it is the series premiere. We got a lot of things going on. Kevin Owens and a mystery partner taking on A-Town Down, Grayson Waller and Austin Theory. A lot of things like who's gonna be Kevin's partner. I think it's Sammy, but Sammy's like, I love Chile, so I think Sammy's in Santiago, Chile. Who knows where he is? Maybe he's back in Mexico hanging out with his good buddy Generico. I don't know. But I mean Kev doesn't have many friends, let's put it that way, but so we'll see what happens tonight. It might be Sam, it might be somebody else. There was a report that Walter would be on the show. The World Heavyweight Champion. That should be interesting. If Sammy's there, you know Walter would be there. But we'll get to that. We'll get that later. What else we got on SmackDown? Roman's on the show tonight. The Tribal Chief. Must acknowledge the Tribal Chief every day. So he will be on the show tonight. Probably be in the final segment. There's going to be something going on. I think the cage match is going to be some chicanery, some weirdness. Maybe, I think what they're going to do is, if it's escape the cage, I don't know what the stipulations are, because it changes every time there's a cage match. But if it's Escape the Cage, I could bet you we're going to get one of those Paul Orndorff, Hogan, Saturday Night Main Event type things where both men hit the floor at the same time. And I'm like, oh, we got to redo the cage match at the end of the night. Or in Hogan and Orndorff's case, they restarted the match. Hogan won, obviously. So they could do that. Cody wins with help from a guy named Roman. Maybe Jimmy Uso shows up tonight. Who knows? Who knows what's going to happen tonight on SmackDown? And there's another rumor that there is a new logo for SmackDown. It's up on Twitter, if you want to go see it. Looks pretty good. I hope they use that. It's pretty damn good. I like the old school logos, but this one looks pretty damn good. Maybe a new stage? Doubt that, but, you know, I wish they brought back the Fist logo. That's fucking Attitude Era / Ruthless Aggression Era SmackDown right there. But I doubt they're ever bring back the Fist. But you never know with Hunter these days. I'm gonna bring back the Fist that I use like it's Stephanie's. Now, whoa, Hunter, stop it. Anyway. What are you talking about? Shut up! Hick and Bonham, go get him. You know? Okay. Whatever. But anyway, that's tonight on SmackDown. Alright. So, we'll talk about that later. Rampage tonight. Later. We'll talk about that later. Alright. Blah, 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 blah. Alright, so, as the title below says, we've got another little, not as a discussion video per se, like I did my last two videos. Thank you for the love and support on those videos. Talk about Julia's debut and my little mega rant about it, you know, how the Japanese wrestlers that all come to WWE, they start off good, and then, so I'm worried about Julia, I'm worried about Stephanie Vaquer, Delta, who's coming in pretty soon, by 2025, I believe. There's another one behind that, I forgot her name, but she's coming in probably by, in 2025 as well. But really, the main people right now is Julia, Delta, and Stephanie Vaquer. I am worried that the WWE is going to fuck them up when they get to the main roster. Not so much NXT. Because, you know, Shawn Michaels knows how to work that talent. But we'll see. We shall see what happens with that. But great debut last week for Julia. I mean, this week for Julia, I should say. And see what's next for her and Roxanne Perez. Or Roxy. We get that. But, so we got that. So check that out. Check out my, is Ring of Honor TV even watchable? I'll tell you what, last night, it is hard to get through. I'm sorry. Ring of Honor TV is just hard to get through sometimes. I mean, some good stuff in between, like with Athena and Billy Starks. Uh-oh, we got Trouble in Paradise. I told you that her reign is almost at 650. She's about to break Joe's record, or if she hasn't broken it yet. She's definitely losing a final battle. There is no doubt in my mind she's finally going to lose that belt at final battle to Billy Starks, the rematch. They're having another match. I think it's their second or third match. And Billy Starks will finally become the Ring of Honor Women's Champion. Because it has to end. If this goes another year, I mean, who's left, basically? All Athena has to do is beat Abaddon, which she probably will be doing soon. And then Billy Starks, you know, at Final Battle again. So she beats Billy Starks again. Who's left? I would think Athena would come out after, after Final Battle, the final tapings of the year. Come out like, I've beaten everybody. I've done everything. I don't need to do this anymore. Drops the belt. We have another boring as fuck tournament for the Ring of Honor Women's Championship. Maybe Billy Starks wins the tournament, then. It's the only way she can win, basically. I don't know, but that's that. Then we just had more stupidity on Ring of Honor TV, you know, with Beef, you know, and Anthony Henry. Oh, I said his name. He appears Anthony Henry. That's who. But Beef! Yeah. Yeah, I like that. He talks like Hunter almost. He's like, yeah, I'm all wet. I'm gonna chill, yeah. Almost like a little Macho Man Randy Savage in there, a little in the voice a little bit. It's Beef, you know. I'm Beef, yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna get my carbs in, yeah. I'm like, okay, calm down. Okay, Macho Man Randy Savage, stop it, you know. Shit. Macho Man Randy Savage, ooh. Yeah! Get it. Calm down. We got that. Alright, so we got that, but Ring of Honor is horrible. That's what I call it. Ring of Horror. Because it's horrible. I really think if Ring of Honor wants to get known, because nobody even watches the product, how about take it to Fox? I mean, you got AEW Shockwave. A little bit of an idea, but don't do those stupid jobber matches. I'm telling you right now, nobody's going to watch. Especially with people that watch, that have Fox 5, and it's a national network. And you're going to get like 200,000 people watching a show on a Friday night, or whenever night it is. Come on now. Come on, Tony Khan. Stop fucking around. And that's that. Alright, so as the title below says, we're going to talk about the Motor City Machine Guns. Alex Shelley and Chris Sabin, multiple time tag team champions, and many promotions, New Japan, CMLL, well, AAA, Ring of Honor, TNA. Well, there is rumors going around. It might be true, but not officially yet. I mean, it's going back and forth. They're officially signing. They're not signing. Alex Shelley kind of teased it. Then he took down the tweet. I think they're going to sign. If you got the Lucha Brothers coming in pretty soon, you know, Rey Fénix and Benny Gunn, Zero, Miedo, they're coming into NXT pretty soon, or at least WWE-wise, they're coming in soon. The Motor City Machine Guns, I think there's a lot of rumors saying they're going to be on the CW 11 Day Butt show, and Shawn Michaels said in a media call that he wants to get at least over a million. Over a million. On the CW11. They could possibly do that. And the thing is, they can't, no overrun, because it's going to do what Fox does and end it like 2-3 minutes early because we got to get to the 10 o'clock news and shit. Blah, blah, blah. So it's going to end at 9:59 and 59 seconds, most likely. Friends, what's up? Here's the news. We got that. So that's probably going to be SmackDown. I'm not SmackDown. NXT on CW coming up in a couple weeks. So, but we got that. But Artemis Motor City Machine Guns coming to WWE? Yes? Maybe? Don't know. We don't know yet. So, but if they do come, I think they're going to be on the CW 11 debut and really go full force in the tag team division. I can just tell you right now, they're going to win the NXT tag team titles, probably from Fraxium, Nathan Frazier, Ben Frazier, and A-Kid. Maybe they have, like, well, there was that, didn't they have, like a, well, I know they, Fraxium won, they retained, I think. No, they had that match with the Street Profits that got ruined by the Bloodline, so I don't know what's going to happen this Tuesday night, but, it's like, I just can't see the Grills of Destiny becoming the NXT Tag Team Champions and the SmackDown Tag Team Champions. I mean, it's not like the Usos holding the SmackDown and Raw tag team titles for like a thousand and some odd days. I mean, it was crazy. But I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do with the Bloodline. I would assume that the Profits are going to get some type of revenge tonight on SmackDown. Because they really didn't. I don't think they didn't. The Cruise of Destiny and Jacob Fatu, you know, Mr. I got my Jumbo Chief. So I'm like, you sound like freaking, what's his name, you know? I know WWE! Not Alex Kozlov, Alex, Vladimir, whatever his name is. But, anyway. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I don't think that, like, Fraxium's gonna, like, hey, we wanna face the Gorillas of Destiny one-on-one for our belts. I don't think that'd be such a great idea. But knowing WWE, they might do that. Who knows? But I think they're gonna Hickenbaum's gonna Ava Rain's gonna come out and say, hey, you know, I got a team for you guys, but I'm not gonna tell you until October the 1st. And then everybody's like, yep, it's gonna be the Machine Guns, or it could be the Lucha Brothers. But both of them are gonna win the tag team belts. That's obvious. And they're gonna put on some banger freaking matches. But do I really want the Machine Guns in WWE? Yes and no. Yes, because they can revitalize the tag team division on the main roster or NXT, mainly NXT. Well, we're pretty much both, I should say. But I'm worried that they're gonna get lost in the shuffle like everybody else has been in the tag team division. Where's the OC? Done, basically. You know, Gallison Anderson and Mia Yim. Really, pretty much, I hate saying the word, but jobbers haven't won much. I mean, they did put on over some talent, like Hank and, well, not so much Hank and Tank, but I think OTM, they put them over in NXT. But basically, that's what they did. They came down to NXT, put people over. Same thing with Mia Yim. Now they're back. Where the fuck is AJ Styles? I'm gonna say AJ Lee. AJ Styles. I think he's taking some time off to be with his family. That I understand that, because he's like 40, almost my age around. But, by the way, but it is what it is. So we'll see what happens with that. I mean, they're like lost in the shuffle. And pretty much, there's not many tag teams around, you know. The Mexican Wolves, Humberto Carrillo, and Angel Garza. Eh, you know. And then you got Raul Mendoza and Joaquin Wild, you know, the LWO, nothing. Grayson Waller and Austin Theory, they were SmackDown Tag Team Champions and then lost, obviously. Lost the belts and to DIY, and then DIY lost to, guess who? Pretty much the Bloodline, but then, and which now became the Gorillas of Destiny's belts, but we got that. And then on Raw, you got The New Day, who, are they breaking up or what? I don't know. You know, and they got Finn Balor and JD McDumfuck as the tag team champions, and then basically you got nothing else. Besides the LWO, I think on Raw, Legado's on, I believe, on SmackDown. The Mexican Wolves, like I said. DIY's on SmackDown. They're still going to be in the division, obviously. Because there's nothing there. The same thing with the Women's Tag Team Championship. Who? I mean, seriously, besides PFC, Pure Fusion Collective, and then you got Kyrie and Io, the Sky Pirates, I mean, and they got the whole Unholy. You got four teams, basically. Maybe five. That's not a division. That's like a freaking carousel. Let's see which one lands on the belts this time. Or a hot potato, basically. I hate when WWE or AEW or any promotion does that shit. Hot potato with the belts. TNA the same way. But not so much with it, you know, ABC and the TNA World Tag Team Champions, Chris Bay and Ace Austin. We got that. And then the Women's Tag Team Champions are the Militia, Alicia Edwards and Masha Slamovich, going back and forth with Spitfire, my girl Danny Luna and Jody Threat. Another match is happening. And tonight's Victory Road, by the way. Not that I care about it, but I mean, we got to see Wendy Choo-choo! You know, against Jordynne Grace for the Knockouts title. I think it was Jordynne, said that, you don't belong here. And then Wendy's like, I'm gonna come, man. I don't need an invitation. Cause guess who she's friends with? Oh, that's right, my girl Rosemary. You don't need an invitation. Fucking Wendy Chu and Rosemary. Come on now, Rosemary invited her. She don't need an invitation. Just say it. But, you know, I mean, I wish the Motor City Machine Guns went back to TNA for their final run. But they're going to be in double. If they're going to be in NXT, I think they're going to have a good run, but not a great run. Or a long run, per se. But, I mean, we'll see what happens with the Machine Guns. And also with the Lucha Brothers. How good of a run. I mean, good run in NXT, main roster, who knows. But, like, everybody that comes up for NXT, depending on who it is, they start off good and then down the drain. Half the time. Most of the time. Unless your name is like Seth Rollins, Drew McIntyre, Roman, Asuka, Kairi in a way, EO, Bayley, Becky, you know? They start off with Becky, she sort of slowed and started she started like going like this a little bit, up. Up, down, up, down, up, down, like my dick in your mom's ass and everything. And then, the whole man gimmick, I'm the man! You know? The man! You know? She was just like, she went into the stratosphere. No pun intended with Trish Stratus, but, you know, with that stuff. Same thing with Sasha. Mercedes. You know, pretty much the four horsewomen. Charlotte, the same thing. Everybody who's come up from NXT has sort of pretty good. And like I said, it depends on who you are. You stay hot and then cool off a little bit. And then you get hot again and then down the drain. Shinsuke Nakamura. I'm just saying with Shinsuke. But that's that. So, I'm worried when Julie goes to the main roster. I'm worried when Roxy goes to the main roster. She's going to be, you know, the same Roxy that we know now. I think she will, but she's probably going to be lost in the shuffle after a while. Probably job. Her first night on Raw or SmackDown, job to somebody like, well, I would not say bad thing. You know, Tiffany Stratton probably beat her or something like that. Or, you know, when Charlotte eventually comes back, she'll, like, bury somebody from NXT. Like she did to Asuka at WrestleMania 32, ending her undefeated streak at over 900 some odd days. And then Asuka's career went boop! Same thing with Shinsuke. Both won the Royal Rumble in 2016. Bye-bye after WrestleMania. I don't know why. I just don't know. That's Vince McMahon booking right there. They're red hot. Should have won the belts. What happens? Shinsuke goes into a feud with AJ over nut shots. And, basically, Asuka kind of started going down the drain. Undefeated streak went bye-bye, and then we all know the story there, but that's, pretty much all I got to say about that. Alright, so that's it for the Motor City Machine Gun story, so let me know your thoughts and opinions about that. Quick ratings news, AEW Dynamite, number 2. On cable on this past Wednesday night, trailing behind the Video Music Awards, yes, that's still a thing, on MTV, which got over 4 million views across, like, 6,000 networks. I saw it on MTV2, I saw it on MTV, it was on the Country Music Channel, what? Country Music Channel, showing the MTV Video Music Awards, and MTV doesn't even play country music? I was like, what? What are we missing? But anyway, I mean, I didn't see all of it. I did see the opening with Eminem. That was epic. I mean, freaking doing what's that freaking song? Hypnotic? Abracadabra. Abracadabra. You know, that song. Then he did a couple other songs, I think, on doing that. Megan Thee Stallion looking hot as the host. They had Katy Perry doing a medley of her songs. Still looking amazing. Making out with Orlando Bloom. I think she's married to him now. Video Vanguard Award. I think she sang a song with Megan Thee Stallion. And that freaking performance was crazy. I turned it up. I guess I watched the beginning and then I stopped watching it. And then I turned it back on and I see Katy Perry, I think it was Megan Thee Stallion and Katy Perry almost scissoring each other on, like, a platform. I'm like, wait a minute, this ain't PG. That's not PG! Right there, Shannon Sharp. You know what I'm talking about. That that Instagram video. Oh my god. He's live on Instagram fucking somebody. Fucking some hot chick. I don't know who the chick was, but we didn't see her, obviously. Dago. What are you doing, man? And then he goes on and says, I was doing what every man should be doing. He's fucking, man, like, come on. It was hilarious. And then he's like, I didn't get hacked. And then freaking R-Truth tries to emulate it, but we you know he's lying. Because we see half of his face, he's like clapping his hands, you know, to emulate, you know, smacking ass and, you know, laying down that pipe and everything. I was like, shut up. Ron told you a moron. Anyway, that was funny, but hilarious. But yeah, I saw Katy Perry and I think Megan Thee Stallion on stage scissoring each other almost. It was like, wow. Nothing wrong with that, but you know, for MTV purposes, yeah, kids watch that shit.
What is this, Daddy?
Yeah. Weird. But still, pretty decent show. I stopped watching after Katy Perry, so. But that was it. But, yeah. So, Dynamite got 728,000 views, up from last week's 699. Also, 0.33 rating in the demo. It's not bad. Could have been higher, but that's pretty much been the norm for AEW Dynamite lately, between 6 and maybe they get around 800,000. Not like the days when they used to get over 1 million, but they haven't hit 1 million, I think, over a year now. At least over a year. It's bad. But, you know, it is what it is. So, going to be on Dynamite the next couple weeks. They got the 50th anniversary show, October the 2nd. And then Title Tuesday, October the 8th. Going head-to-head with NXT, which is going to be from St. Louis, Missouri, with Randy Orton as well, this voice, and a whole lot more. So, you know Dynamite's losing that night by a lot. I mean, a lot. I bet you Dynamite will probably get like 200,000-300,000. They're probably the lowest rating ever. I mean, ever in their 5 years. It'd be bad, because nobody's going to watch Dynamite. Everybody's going to watch NXT. Because everybody can watch NXT now, because it's on the CW11. Everybody in America can get it. If you want, and pretty much everyone in the world can get it, because you have the CW app. But, I mean, we'll see what happens with that. Speaking of NXT, let's see what NXT's ratings were this week. NXT... for this week, 628,000 views. Ouch. It's got a 0.19 rating in the demo. Demo rose nearly 12%. Okay, 12%. But you still got 628,000 views. And this is going head-to-head with that horrible debate, by the way, between that bitch, Kamala Harris, and our future president, Donald Trump. But what a waste of a night that was. For obvious reasons. 3-on-1, basically a 3-on-1 handicap match against Trump. I mean, it's disgusting. And he was getting fact-checked every 5 seconds by these idiots at ABC News, which is fake news. You are fake news. So, I don't even think there's going to be another debate. There shouldn't be one. I think. That depends on Trump and Mr. Trump and his team, if they actually want to go round two with Kamala Harris, but go on a better network like Fox News or NBC or something like that. Basically Fox, because Fox loves Trump. That's a fact, too. Not so much CNN, per se, but I would go back to CNN or Fox News. That's my opinion, but, you know, we got that. NXT, actually, October 1st, the CW11 show, is going head-to-head with the vice presidential debate between J.D. Vance and Tim Walz, which could be pretty good, but, I mean, I'm not going to watch it. I'm not going to care. But Who knows if they're going to have another one? It's October. What are they going to do? Have another one? It's like, let's have a debate now, and then, like the week of Halloween, we're going to have another one a few days before the debate. Okay, good idea. Maybe a good idea. But I mean, what matters is November the 5th. We're 52, 53 days away from that. So get out and vote, you fuckers! And vote for the right person, that's Donald Trump. But that's another story for another time. And that's pretty much it. Alright guys, I gotta go, I gotta run some errands, I gotta run to the supermarket, get a couple deals, because I need some extra soda and everything. So I'm gonna go out, grab a couple things at the supermarket, come back, have my sensible lunch, and then I'll be back with two more videos coming your way before SmackDown comes your way at 8 o'clock. So NXT and AEW, right here on the channel, so three videos, back to back to back on this channel. You gotta love it. And that's pretty much it. So stay tuned. More videos coming your way. Please hit that bell. Hit that subscribe button down below if you missed anything. But if you missed anything, you missed it. But if you have subscribed and you missed it, well, get to watch the replay, I guess. But because all my great people on the replay crew, I love you. And that's pretty much it. So check it out on the replay. If you're new and like what you see, hit that subscribe button. We're at 612 subscribers right now. I don't know how many we're going to get by the end of the year. Maybe 700. Maybe get close to 725, 750. I mean, I don't care, but, you know, it'd be nice. But I know it's not going to happen, but I take what I get. And that's all I got to say about that. But if you love wrestling, you love music, check out my Metal Guy channel. You want the best rants on YouTube, then you came to the right place. PG Rants. You want more wrestling talk and wrestling reviews, go to my main channel, my Kill the Demons channel. And if you want predictions and some vlogs in there, some random stuff, talk about football previews for the season, baseball as well. I might do one for hockey. I doubt it with the Rangers. You know, preseason hockey I think starting this weekend actually. That should be fun. They already painted the ice, the red lines and all that shit at the Garden already. So I think it's Sunday they their first preseason game. So you're getting good, baby. You've got a baseball pretty much 2 weeks away. 18 games left for them. I believe 16 or 18 games for the Mets. Big, huge. Next few series for the Mets. They have a big series this weekend in Philadelphia against the Phillies. Not going to be easy because we got Aaron Nola tonight, and then I think their second and third starter tonight. Tyler McGill pitches. Quintana pitches tonight. I don't trust that guy. And then I think we got Severino this weekend. I think Manaea as well. Should be good. Hopefully, the Bats did wake up Wednesday, break up that no-hitter, and the Mets just scored 6 runs to win that game. You know, so big win there. One game up in the wild card. I don't know who the Braves play this weekend, but they're coming up in a week from Tuesday in Atlanta. That might decide if the Mets are going to the playoffs or they're going to be sitting home again, but we'll see what happens with that. But the next 16 to 18 games for the Mets are huge. Got the Nationals at home next week, the Phillies next weekend, then to Atlanta. I think they got the Marlins in between that, and then got Milwaukee, which means the good land, to end the season in 2 weeks from Sunday. So it's getting close, it's getting dicey. And you know, with the Yankees kind of back and forth with the Orioles. So the Yankees are most likely going to make the playoffs if they don't in the next, you know, 15 to 16 games. But I think they're not going to go anywhere in the playoffs. I don't think they're going to go to the World Series. I mean, if they do, great, but they're going to lose. But we'll see. We'll see. That starting pitching, besides Gerrit Cole, sucks so bad. Their bullpen is garbage. Clay Holmes is turning into like Armando Benitez / Edwin Diaz. He's good, but then he's like, garbage. Aldous Chapman, too, from the Yankees. You know, you have no closer ever since Mariano Rivera left. No great closer. He stinks. He stinks, you know. So, I mean, we'll see what happens with that. If the Yankees win the division, and the Orioles get the number one seed in the wild card, or the Yankees get the top seed, they still get home games for the wild card round. But, and I think the division round, I think they have to buy it. I don't know how that works, but see what happens with that. But Mets are two games back of the Padres and the Diamondbacks, and they're going to cancel each other out near the end of the year. So the Mets can, if they're on the roll that they're on right now, probably the best record since May the 30th, which is crazy. 55, 56 wins. 56 and 23 or 50, something like that. 55 and 23, 57 and 23, somewhere around that area. Mets are red hot since the Grimace era. You know, it is still kind of the Grimace / hot tour era. It just can't be stopped right now. I just hope, you know, these last 2 weeks they don't, you know, that they've done in the past. But, I mean, not going to be easy with the with six against the Phillies. You got Atlanta, three more against Atlanta. You got the Nationals, who are always pesky. And then Milwaukee, which really, they're just playing for nothing, really. Maybe home field through the playoffs, the National League. That's that, but really, the Brewers got nothing to play for against the Mets in that series. Mets could sweep them and still get in the playoffs. But I doubt that, because I think it's in Milwaukee. So, I mean, we'll see. We'll see what happens with all that. When we get to the end of the season for the Mets, just got the Titans this weekend at 1 o'clock. Probably lose that game. I mean, maybe, who knows, but the Giants got the Commanders in Washington, D.C. I think the Commanders are going to wipe the floor with them. Both games at 1 o'clock, so I'm going to have to, you know, do what I owe. And the Niners game's at 1, I'm like, shit. But they're not going to be televised because I have to watch on the app because the Giants are on at 1 at the fucking same time. Niners got the Vikings in Minnesota where they haven't won in a long time. So, it's not going to be easy against Sam Darnold, no, and company. But, you know, Sam Darnold is so up and down, it's like, it's insane. So, I think the Niners' defense is going to wallop them. Hey, I remember you, and we're going to wallop you now. Not that you did anything last year on the Niners, but same. But, we got that. You know, last night's game, Bills just destroyed freaking Miami in Miami, and Tua got hurt again. And the way he got hit, it felt like last year. He got hit, and he's like, and his hands started like being weird and everything. He got hit by Damar Hamlin. Remember that? What happened to him? He was out for like a year, and he came in, you know, just a scare. Well, probably one of the most scariest fucking things I've seen on TV, next to the Joe Theismann broken leg thing. Ugh. Nasty, back in the 80s, but, yeah, Tua got hurt last year almost the same way, not the same way as Joe Theismann, I'm just saying, the same way he got hit last year, so he's gonna be, he's out this week, oh, well, he's out now, they don't play until next Sunday, so, he's gonna be, I think he might not even make it the next week, because I think he's got a concussion, or I don't know what he has, but he got rocked by Hamlin yesterday. And Hamlin's like, you know, my prayers go out to my boy, Tua, for sure, you know, everything like that. So, yeah, prayers go to Tua. Great quarterback, but you might want to, you know, have to slide a couple times, you know. He keeps doing what he's doing and the way he gets hit. He's going to end up in the ER for life, or he's going to die on the field. I don't want it. I hate saying that, and I don't want it to happen, but God forbid, you know, we have a death on the field. I mean, Damar Hamlin, the way he got hit, and he wasn't moving for like 5 minutes. I think he was like almost, I think they said he wasn't moving, wasn't breathing, so I think he was like he wasn't like breathing for like 5 minutes, so he's like technically dead for 5 minutes, and he came back. Thank God for that. I didn't want to see that. And like, I think it was not a playoff game. It was like before the playoffs, I think. But You know, but he recovered and he came back for the playoffs. Big, that whole thing. And then the home opener, that was great. But he's back, he's playing. You gotta worry about, you know, his neck and everything. So, I mean, great consummate professional football player, but same thing with Tua, but, you know, Tua, you gotta calm down. I know these quarterbacks, they're trying to get the first down, but, you know, either you slide or, you know, if you can take the hit, good, but if not, God bless your mighty soul, depending on the person who hits you. Like, if Fred Warner hits you, you're done, pretty much. Bosa, too. But Hamlin got him. He popped him pretty good. And then it was a meaningless freaking first down. They were losing by 20-something points. And then he goes, he runs, he finds a seam, gets the first down a little bit more right near the end zone, and then Hamlin just popped him. I think he tried to dive, and like Hamlin hit him. It looked like he didn't even hit him. That hard, like full-on hit. Like he like dove and kind of like maybe maneuvered a little bit. I mean, just look at the hit. I don't think it was a bad hit, but it was nasty. The way that, you know, you see Tua like, ugh, you know, the same way he was last year. With his hands like all numb and like shit. I was like, ugh, that's crazy. But hopefully he gets better, you know. The Dolphins season pretty much revolves around that. So right now, I know it's week two right now, Dolphin fans, I mean. But I think you might want to invest in a quarterbacks, because I don't know who their backup is and who the backup to that is. The emergency quarterback, but I mean, I don't even, like I said, I don't know how long Tua is going to be out for. Maybe a couple weeks. At least next week, at least. I mean, we'll have to see what happens with that. All right, guys, I am out of here. Thanks for watching. I'll be back later. But until next time, put your comments down below about the AEW NXT ratings and about the Motor City Machine Guns possibly coming to NXT along with the Lucha Brothers. So we got that. All right, guys, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching, and until next time. If you're not down with that, well, fuck you, man. That's it. Have a happy Friday the 13th. Watch out for Jason Voorhees. That's pretty much all I gotta say about that. Until next time.